Hey everyone, welcome back, and if you're new here, then welcome to my channel. In this video, I will show you how I made this Gothic style candle centerpiece using a Dollar Tree pull noodle. So if you want to see how I made it, then please keep watching. So first, I'm going to be using one of these pull noodles. I picked this up from the Dollar Tree. Okay, so next I'm going to be taking my pull noodle and I'm just going to be cutting it to various lengths. The length just depends on how many candles you want and how tall or how short you want your candles to be. So I'm just going to go in and cut them at random, not any particular length. And some of these I will be cutting straight across the top, and then I may have a couple of them where I go in at an angle, so that they're kind of tapered. Okay, so I was able to get 6 candles out of one pull noodle. Okay, so next I'm going to take one of the little tea light candles. I got mine from Dollar Tree. I'm going to take the pull noodles and I'm just going to, where this hole is, I'm going to place the candle right over that. And then I'm going to go through with a marker or a pencil or pen or whatever and just trace around the candle. So this gives us an idea of how big we need to cut out a little hole here so that our candle will fit down inside it. So to cut the hole, I am going to be using an X-Acto knife. Just be very, very careful. And I'm just going to go through and just cut around where I traced that circle. And then I'm going to go through down inside the pull noodle and kind of go across a little bit. So then we can remove that little ring. So I'm going to set the candle down in there just to see how much deeper I need to go. This is up to you. If you want your candle to stick up a little more, that's fine. I kind of want mine to be a little more flush. So I'm going to go ahead and cut down just a little bit more. Okay, so the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take one of these silicone molds. Now, I got this one. My mom had given it to me, but I think that she got it from Walmart, and it has fingers and bones on it. Dollar Tree does sell silicone molds. This one is the vampire teeth, and I did get this, I don't know, it's been 2 or 3 years ago, but I do know that they still carry the silicone molds at Dollar Tree during this time of year. So I'm going to be using this one with the bones and the fingers. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take some hot glue and I'm just going to start putting the hot glue in the bone, the sections where the bones are. I'm not going to put fingers on it, but the bones. So I'm just going to start squirting my hot glue down into the silicone mold here. Okay, so now our mold has set up, so I am going to go ahead and take them out. I've already removed one of them, and as you can see where some of this hot glue, you know, is a little bit stringy, I'm just going to go in with a pair of scissors and trim those off. Okay, so the next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to use one or two of these skull. These are the DIY stickers that you can get from the Dollar Tree. I'm going to use maybe one or two of those. I'm also going to use maybe one or two of these stickers. I think I'm going to be using these that are in the middle. I also got these from the Dollar Tree. Sorry about the glare. And then I'm also going to be adding our little hot glue, the bones that we made with using the molds. So I'm just going to add these randomly to the candles. I am not going to be adding anything to all of the candles, just to a couple of them. So I'm going to go ahead and show you guys what I'm going to do. So for this taller candle, I think that I am going to be using one of these stickers out of this package here. And I think I'm going to grab this one right here that says love on it. And it's okay if I don't have this part of it, because I don't need it. So I'm going to take the larger candle here, and I'm just going to kind of eyeball where the middle of it is. So it's probably going to go about right here. And I think to give it some extra hold, I'm going to be adding some hot glue to it. I think I'm also going to be adding these little swirly bits right here. Okay, so for the next candle, it is the next to the tallest. So I'm going to add one of these stickers to it also. So it doesn't really matter which one. I don't want that wording, that forever wording on there. So I'm just going to hot glue this into place. Okay, so for my next candle, I'm going to be adding one of these DIY stickers with the skull. I think I'm just going to be adding one of these plain wooden skulls here. So I'm just going to figure out where I want this one to go. And I think I kind of want to make it a little taller, a little higher up. So I'm going to go ahead. This one does have a little sticker on the back there, but I'm going to go ahead and add some hot glue anyway. Okay, so on this one, I think I'm going to go ahead and add a couple of these hot glue bones that we made using the silicone mold. So I'm just going to place these sort of in just random spots on the candle. And I am using hot glue to attach them. Okay, so for the remaining two bones, I am just going to be doing the same thing. I'm going to hot glue one on the back here, sort of crooked, and then I'm going to hot glue the other one on the back at an angle also. I'm going to be adding some drips to our candles. So I'm just going to be taking some hot glue, and I'm just going to start squeezing some hot glue all over around the top of the candle here. going to start kind of dripping it down the side of the candle. Since this candle is the shorter of the candles, I'm going to really pile up the hot glue on this. So what I'm going to do is let the first layer of hot glue dry, and then I'll come back in and start adding some more drips. Okay, so this is kind of starting to set up a little bit, so I'm going to go through and add some more glue across the top here. Okay, so now I have a second layer, so I'm going to go ahead and let that dry a little bit, and then I'm going to come back in. I'm going to add another layer. Okay, so here is what the smallest candle is looking like so far. So I am going to go ahead and continue on to the other candles, and I'm just going to be doing the same exact thing where I am dripping the hot glue down them just until I get it looking the way that I want it to. Okay, so now I'm done putting the hot glue on my candlesticks. Next, I'm going to be taking them outside and giving them two coats of this Rust-Oleum American Accents. This is the 2x Ultra Coverage Ultimate Ultra Matte and the color black, and I did pick this spray paint up from Walmart. Next, I'm going to take one of the Dollar Tree skulls, and I'm going to be giving it one coat of the Waverly chalk paint in the color plaster. Okay, so I have one coat of the plaster paint on there. Next, I'm going to go in, I'm going to fill in his eyes, the nose, and some details around the teeth, and I'm going to be using the Waverly chalk paint and the color ink. So far, here is what my skull is looking like. Next, I'm going to be dry brushing on a combination of different colors. I'm going to be using the apple barrel paint, the country gray, and also khaki. I will just be dry brushing this all over the skull, just trying to add some detail and things like that to it, just to make it look a little more realistic. So now my candles are all painted, and I just thought I'd show you guys kind of what they are looking like. There's this one. I think that looks really, really cool. And then this one. So, and then these other two here, I didn't put anything on them, but I did add quite a bit of the hot glue to make them look like they were melted down pretty good. So the next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to be taking this paint pen. I picked this up from the Dollar Tree. This is in a gold color, and I'm just going to try to color in where I placed these little embellishments on, just to get these to kind of stand out a little bit. So I'm just going to go through and kind of paint these with my paint marker here. I'm going to be taking one of these charger plates. I picked mine up from the Dollar Tree. This one is gold, and I am just going to leave it gold. I'm not going to be painting it or anything like that. So The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to start hot gluing my candles onto my platter here. And first I want to just kind of set them up where I think I might want them to go. So now I have my candles placed where I want them, and I wanted to make sure that I do have some space to add a skull, and I think I may also add a flower or a spider or something like that there. So now that I have these where I want them, I am just going to start hot gluing them in place. Here's my skull. I added some gold colored paint to kind of match with the gold plate and the gold that is on the candles. So I'm going to be hot gluing him down to the plate. So I just want to find where I want him to go. Next, I'm going to be adding one of these giant flowers. I got this from Dollar Tree. This is a dahlia clip. And what I plan on doing is taking that same gold paint pen, and where this flower has the silver glittery type accents on it, I'm going to go through with my gold paint marker and just color those in gold. So wherever the silver glitter is, that is where I'm going to be coloring it in gold. So I'm going to go ahead and do that, and then I'll be right back. Next, I'm going to be hot gluing some of this Spanish moss that I picked up from the Dollar Tree. I want to be placing it around the charger plate in the sections where it looks empty, like it needs a little bit of something. So here's the flower after I've put some of that gold paint on there. And I did get a little carried away right here where it came out really fast. But that's okay. So I don't think it'll be that noticeable. So what I'm going to do now is take the clip that's on the back. I'm going to take that off of there. And where this spot right here is sticking up, I'm going to snip that off. Okay, so I've got the back snipped off there. So now I'm just going to hot glue it down where I want it. So I'm just going to take some hot glue. I'm going to put some back here. And then I kind of just want to tuck it back in the midst of these candles here. And I'm going to hold that down. Let the glue kind of set up a little bit. Okay, so there is what it looks like so far with the flower and everything on there. So the next thing that I'm going to do is I'm just going to add a little spider. This came in, I think it was a pack with some spider webbing. So anyway, I'm just going to be hot gluing this to the top of the skull. Okay, so the last thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to add some of these tea lights. I picked these up from Walmart. You can also get these from the Dollar Tree, but I have not been able to find the black tea lights at my Dollar Tree, so I had to get mine from Walmart. So I'm just going to be adding the tea lights to this. Now, if you want to, you can always drape some spider webbing across this to make it look a little more spooky. It's totally up to you. So anyway, I'm going to go ahead, add my lights. Make sure you stay tuned till the end so that you can see pictures of what this looks like displayed. Here is how the project turned out. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please hit that subscribe button because I would love to have you. I hope you all are having a wonderful day. I wanted to thank you all for watching, and I'll talk to y'all later. Bye!